Good afternoon, dear students. Assalamu alaikum. Hello, my dear students, guardians, and whoever with me now. Just I like to welcome to my today's class. I welcome you all from the core of my heart. Okay. Before starting my today's class, I like to request my students, that is, please invite your friends who are not yet coming, and please call them, share the video, so that together we can enjoy a very nice class. Okay, I'm sharing from my timeline so that. Yes, I'm sharing it. So that all of my friends and the students connected with me, they can easily see the class and get benefited. Okay, so. And I also request you to everyone, please share the video. Within a very short time, I will start my class. Okay. Yes, did it? Yes, Firoza Yasmin. Hello, hello, dear. Edu Bid. BD, assalamu alaikum. Nafisa, hello ma'am, hello. Shunil Haldar, hi ma'am, hello. Assalamu alaikum, wa alaikum assalam. Please call everyone so that I can see Zinat is with me. Welcome, welcome to my today's class. Yes, Mahi, hello, hello dear. Aroti Ghosh, assalamu alaikum. Situn Nabila Siddiqa ma'am, assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, I will introduce myself. Just wait. Okay. Hello Jasmine Appa, how are you? Thank you for watching. Yes, I'm fine. Yes, assalamu alaikum. I can see that lots of students have already joined, and I can see there are lots of colleagues also with me. So before starting my today's class, who are new with me, I just like to introduce myself. Okay, so this is Farzana Anwar. I'm working in Ikkhu Gabeshana High School, BSRI Ishwardeep Pabna, and this is class English, class 8. Okay, and you know there are two parts in English, first part and second part. So in this time I'm with you for English for today, and as the routine was published, you know, so I will today take the class unit 6 lesson 2, and the title is filling in a form, that is the filling in a form. Okay, so just one more time. Yeah, good Aruti, be engaged. Yes, I will just talk to you now. Okay, Jahidul Islam, hello, I'm fine, thank you. Hope all of you are also fine by the grace of Allah. Okay, so let's start it. Okay, so this is the class. After the class, what we will learn from our today's text. Okay, just this is the summary, that after studying today's class, we will be able to use some new words. We will listen for information, that means we will listen some text for gathering the information, and we will read and understand text, that means we are going to read a text, and of course we will understand it, and of course fill in a form, that is we will be able to fill in a form, so that every time, you know, we the students, we people are facing, we are struggling to filling the form. Okay, so after doing today's class, I think we will not be able to face any problem in filling the form. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so what can you see, dear students? Actually, when I give you any question, please type the answer as soon as possible, because this is not a new class for you. This is a revision class, isn't that? This class already you have attended in the Shongshok television. So this is just the problem solving class. So what is the problem? You just ask me and I will. Rafiqul Islam, camera ta thik position e nei, bhalo kore dekha jacche na. Okay, any other person, can you tell me? It is my problem or the others device problem? Farhana Mahmood, yes, dekha jacche na. But in my device it's clear. देखा जाच्छे ना ठीक करे ताओ देखा जाच्छे ना ओके आई एम ट्राइंग देखा जाच्छे ना नाउ यस आई हैव ऑलरेडी फिक्स इट कैन यू यस राजीव आलम सर कैन यू प्लीज मेक ए कमेंट फिक्स योर कैमरा व्हाई दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम एक्चुअली आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिड दिस Probably it is the net issue, because all the thing is okay. Shamima Nasreen, yes, ami bhalo achi. Dekha jacche, yes, thank you Kaniz Akhtar. Dekha jacche, that means everything is okay. Yes, camera is not clear. Sir, can you please check your device, because some of I got some response that they are watching clearly. Jacche, okay, fine. So thank you. Now it's okay. Mine is clear. Yes, actually it is net issue, so I can see that. Rafia ma'am, camera ta arektu close korle bhalo hote pare. No ma'am, somebody is saying that they are okay. Zoom hoye ache. Okay, yes, no problem. Okay, whoever are facing problem, please check the device of your, or the maybe it may be any other issue. Okay, let's check. But some I got the reply that everything is okay. Yes, Sharia, this is class 8 English first paper. Okay, now look at the form. What can you see in the picture? Okay, so this is just a plain form. Okay, have you seen this form before? If yes, where? The first question is where. Now please type the answer. Where have you seen this type of form? Okay, so do it quickly, all the students. Yes, who are with me, please write down the answer. Where have you seen this form? Okay, it's a very easy question for you, as it is a red text for you. Yes, already I have started, no problem, thank you. Yes, okay, Fahmida Shuli, this is class 8 in the airport. Okay, yes, Raisa said it is in the airport. Yes, Raisa said it is in the airport. She have noticed. Yes, airport, immigration. Yes, so I'm getting the answer. So thank you, dear students. So this is the form you have seen in the airport. Okay, if your answer is no, so everyone may not have gone to airport. So where you can you guess? When it is needed, because we have already learned this lesson and this is a seen form. We have, at least we have seen this form in our textbook. Okay, so this is the form, and look here, it is a departure card, bohirgomon card. When somebody is going to another country, then we need this form. Okay, so thank you very much for giving the right answer. So before entering the our text, let's discuss some vocabulary. Okay, so our today's new word is expire. Our first one is expire. Okay, expire. This is, look at the picture. Okay, can you relate this picture with this word? In this picture, we can see a strip of medicine. There is a manufacturing number and there is the expiring date. Manufacturing date and expiring date. Manufacturing date, when it is produced, and expiring date, when it will be of no use. So this is expiring date. We can easily see that. Okay, just try to guess the meaning. Okay, now let's see the example. My library card will expire next week. My library card, I have a card and it will expire next week. Good. Now, what would be the meaning? To lapse and become invalid. Lapse means batil hoye jawa, bad pore jawa. Okay, and become invalid. That means it is of no use. Invalid hawa, boitho ta na thaka. Okay, so the expire means kono kichur karjokarita harano. Good. So this is a verb. As it is an action, expire, so this is a verb. Okay, so I think you have got the meaning of the word expire. Now let's go to our next word, renew. Renew. Okay, so what is the meaning of this renew? Look at the passport here. Okay, here we can see two passport. One person is allowed to get one passport, but if it has expired its date, so he or she has to renew it. Okay, so just I have a passport here. Can you see? Here are two passport. This one is my first one, and when the date was expired, then I got this one. This is my new. So I have renewed my passport. So what is the meaning? Let's look at another example. I have to renew my passport as it is expired last month. Okay, so expire, we have already known this word. Je ei passport er date over hoye geche. Okay, so I have to renew my passport. Okay, so what is the meaning? To make new again. Okay, so what is the meaning? To make new again. Okay, so and it is verb, and it is verb. Okay, now let's see this word, visa. Visa, it's a very frequently uttered word when you are willing to go outside or visit any foreign country. Look at this picture. Can you relate this? This is picture of a visa, and here where it is stamped, it is stamped on a passport. Can you see here? Yes, look here. This is a, can you see? This is a stamp. It is stamped on a passport. So this is the visa. So what could be the meaning? Can you guess? Okay, the man got his visa to visit India. The man got his visa to visit India. So you know the meaning. Let's check the meaning with the example. A formal permission, that is, a visa is a formal permission to enter and leave a country. Okay, so what is the meaning? A formal permission to enter and leave a country. If you want to enter a country or leave the country, you want some permission. And this visa is that very permission, and it is a formal, not oral or informal. Okay. And which parts of speech is this word? This is a noun. This is a noun. Good. Our next word is valid. Valid. Okay. Can you repeat after me? Valid. V. V. Please utter with me. V. Valid. Okay. So, let's see the license. This is a valid license. How do we know this is a valid? Because it is issued 12 March 2014 and its validity is 11 March 2024. This is 2020 and it will be valid 2024. So this is a valid license. Okay. Look at the example. Please do not drive without a valid license. So what would be the meaning? Acceptable, proper or correct. Something that is acceptable. Anyone or the authority can accept it and it is proper or correct. So that is valid. So what would be the parts of speech? It is adjective. It is adjective. Very good. So I think you understood these words. Okay, now this is quiz time. So what we have learned so far, let's check. Okay, so what we have learned? We have learned some new words from today's text. Okay, so I think this would be very easy for you. So just get ready and you will just start to type. As soon as I can see the comment, I will know that you have understood the vocabs or not. Okay, so this is, yes, can you see? These are the clues. You have to put anyone. These are the options. From these options, you have to choose the word and fill in the blanks. Okay, oh dear, I'm very eager to visit Thailand, but I can't because I have no dash and I must dash my passport. So these are the clues. Valid, renew, passport and visa. Okay. So just, okay, do it quickly. Fast. Yes. Okay, I'm waiting your answer, waiting for your answer. Please do the comment. Please do the comment. I know you will do it. Yes. Yes. Yes, the answer is coming. Answer is coming. Okay, Atiful Alom, a passport and renew. Okay, Atiful Alom, can you check your answer again? Yes, Raisa, I got your answer. A visa, B, renew. Okay, Waqib Babu, passport renew. Okay, those who are writing passport, just can you see the sentence? Oh dear, I have very eager to visit Thailand, but I can't because I have no dash and I must dash my passport. That means I have my passport. Actually, I have my passport. So what I don't have? So please write it here. Okay. Renew, B, renew, good. A visa, renew, Kaniz Akhtar, congratulations. Yes, Atau Rahman, thank you. Visa, renew. Sadiqul Alam, I don't know why. Visa renew. Sharia, thank you. Thank you so much. So attentive students you are. So engaging. I'm really proud of you. Really proud of you. SH Pritham, visa renew. Yeah. Passport. Oh no. No, it is not passport. Soundcom. Can anyone tell me sound is okay or not? The other students, somebody says that sound is low. Sorry, yeah, visa renew. Yeah, thank you, Nabil. Thank you. You corrected your answer. So actually, answer is coming. These are the right answer. So I have no visa. Yes, I have no visa, and I must renew my passport because I have a passport, but it has lost its validity. So I have to renew my passport. So this is renew and this is visa. Thank you. Nice students. Now let's go to the text. Okay. Mita's full name is Mita Sultana Ahmed. Mita's full name is Mita Sultana Ahmed. Dear students, I know you have the textbook with you. Please open the text and just match the reading with my reading. Okay. She was born on 6 May 1998. She got her passport on June 9, 2010. It's a 5-year passport. Look, 5 year. This is not 5 years. Okay. 5 is plural. So you can say years. No. This is 5-year passport. That is mead. Passported mead 5 bachor. 5 bachor meadi passport. Good. So this is called 5 year. 5 year passport. This is one word. Okay. Her passport number is AB984-2251. She is going to Thailand by Bangladesh Biman flight number BG88 on July 14, 2012. So this is BG88 and this is a passport. You can see, and this is a 5-year passport. So this is all about the information of Mita. Now, dear students, I like to read this part of the text from your book so that you can understand that if you are able to read it or not. Okay. Mita's full name is Mita Sultan Ahmed. She was born on 6 May 1998. She got her passport on June 9, 2010. Lots of information is here. It's a 5-year passport. So how long the passport is validity? 5 year. Her passport number is AB984-2251. She is going to Thailand by Bangladesh Biman flight number BG88 on July 14 and 2012. Okay, so this is the first part. So why I am just giving the segment? Because after this part you have to fill in a form for Mita. So please look at the information, open your book, and now let's do the activity 1. Okay, so what is in activity 1? This is a number 1 to 8. There is the form. You will fill the form for Mita. Okay, so suppose name. So what will you write here? The name of Mita. Okay, suppose Mita is filling the form and you are Mita, and just fill in the form. Okay, take help from your textbook. Name, yes, write it there. Sex, that is male or female. If you are a boy, you are male. If you are a girl, you are female. And this is date of birth, as it is we are doing this form for Mita. So Mita is a girl, so this is female. Okay, so date of birth in the text, we have got Mita's date of birth. Nationality, we know where she was born, so you will write it here. Passport number in the text, there is that passport number of Mita. And date of expiry, when it will get expiration, you have known it. And flight number, you will write it here. And date of departure, that means when she is leaving Bangladesh. Okay, date of departure, you will write the date here. So one thing I like to mention here, day, you will write first the day, that means the today's date. Number, suppose today is 17, this is, you will write 17 month June 06 and 2020. But this is just an example. You will write it from the text. Okay. So please do it. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Okay. Oh, that's nice, Sharmin Mahi. Your name is Mita. Very good. Nice. Thank you, Firoza. Yes, please write the. Yeah, enjoying. Thank you. I know. Please write the answer. Yes, Mita Sultana Ahmed. Good name. Yes, Papia Sultana has already written. Congratulations, Papia. You are so attentive. Thank you. So lovely student. So six. This is Mita. Yes, female. Bangladeshi. Okay, date of birth. Papia, please write the date of birth. Mahbuba Khanom. Assalamualaikum. Waalaikumsalam. Yes. Please complete the form. Nationality, Bangladeshi. Very good. Very good. Yes. Passport number. Anybody got the passport number? Please write the passport number of Mita's, from Mita's information. Yeah, I'm waiting for the answer. Just look at the text. Yes, thank you Aruti Ghosh. AB9842251, thank you. Mita Sultan Ahmed, nice. We have just finished number 5. Go to the expiry date, please. Expiry date, write down the expiry date when the date will be finished. Look, the where is the expiry date? She got her passport on 9/2010. It's a 5-year passport. So 5 year, after 5 year it will be expired. Okay, so what, when will be the expiry date? Please add 5 with the issued date. Okay. Joinul Abedin, this is not your form. Please write it for Mita. This is for Mita. Next, I will go for you. Okay, Mahbuba Khanum, ami derite eshechi. Okay, this is class 8, English, unit 6, lesson 1. Please go quickly, open the book. Passport number, yes, 8 June. Yes, Kaniz Akhtar, 8 June 2015. June, 8 June, yes, thank you, Kaniz Akhtar. Very good. Lots of right answers. Ashraf Ahmed, 23. Why 23? I don't get your answer. Yes, 2015. Yes, Ahsan Habib. Congratulations. So very nice students. Expire date means jedin validity ta shesh hoye jabe. কার্যকারিতার হারাবে সেই ডেটটা হচ্ছে ভ্যালিডিটি ডেট. ওকে, ইয়া 2015. ওকে, নাইস, থ্যাংক ইউ. সো দি ইউ গট ইউর অল দ্য রাইট আনসার্স অ্যান্ড ফ্লাইট নাম্বার. আই ডিডন্ট গেট দ্য ফ্লাইট নাম্বার. আই ওয়ান্ট দিস আনসার. বাংলাদেশ বিমান ফ্লাইট নাম্বার, ইট ইজ ভেরি ক্লিয়ার. ওকে, ফ্লাইট নাম্বার, লুক এট here. Yes, Abdul Rashid, you are right. Thank you. So flight number BG88, Bangladesh Biman, flight number BG88. Excellent. Okay, Shariar, why 29 June? Okay, can you check the date please, Shariar? It is 9 June 2013. 2015, not 12-13. Yes, BG 88. BG 88, right. Raisa, right. Congratulations, Raisa. You are doing well. BG 88. And then, yes, BG 88. Okay, let's move to the date of departure. When Mita is going to another country, when she is visiting Thailand, okay, that is the departure date. Okay, yes, this time I want the date. I want the date. Look at the date on July 14, 2012. Yes, I'm getting, yeah, Atiful Alam, Nabil, thank you Nabil. 14 July 2012, thank you. So right answer are coming, so I think you got this part. Thank you very much. Let's move to our next part of the text. Okay, Mita got her visa from the Royal Thai Embassy. Look at the picture. This is Royal Thai Embassy in Dhaka. Her visa number is T9115138. The visa is issued in Dhaka on 29 June 2012. This visa is valid for 3 months. So, validity duration, 3 months. Okay. It will expire in September 27, 2012. Okay. So, this is the expiration date of Mita's visa. So, we have two formal words. One is passport, one is visa. This is all about visa. Okay. Visa will expire in September 27, 2012. It is a tourist visa. So, what is the type of the visa? It is a tourist visa, as Mita is the traveler. Okay. If you are traveling on a tourist visa, that means when somebody is going abroad as a tourist, you got a tourist visa, and what will happen? You will not allow to study or work there. If you are a student there, you are not allowed to study or work. You just visit, you will travel, and then you will return. This is the formalities. So, this is the all informations are about visa. Where Mita got that visa? From the Royal Thai Embassy in Dhaka. This is the picture, and this is the just a sample visa for the Thailand. Okay. And it is also a tourist visa. So, you can just see this, read the text from your textbook, and finally, we will again fill in a form for this part. Okay. So, read it very carefully and very quickly within 1 minute. This is a very short passage. Okay. So, read this part very quickly. Yes, let's see. Yeah, Shilpi Rani Shaha. Yes. Actually, the answer is moving so far. So many students are commenting. Thank you. Thank you. Somebody says, I don't got my answer. So, can you please write your answer again? Because I didn't get your question. Please write the question again. Yeah, visa number. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Asan Habib. It's a very nice. Okay, thank you, Aruti. Visa number, very good. So, there are also some more information. Please notice the information. Good. Very good. Yes. Okay. So, I can see that lots of students are joining still now, and they are not getting the question, which class is this? This is class 8. Yes. Very good. Very good. Okay. Nice. Tourist June. Okay, Papia Sultana, thank you. You got lots of information. Thank you. Now, let's go to the activity 2. Okay, so this is our activity 2. And for that part, we will complete this form. Okay, so where it is? Address in Bangladesh for foreigners. So, you need not fill up this part. Okay, this is only for the foreigners who come to Bangladesh and who are living Bangladesh. Okay, so this is not for us. We the Bangladeshis. Mita is a Bangladeshi, so this is not valid for her. Okay, Bangladeshi Nagoriker Jonno, that means for Bangladesh nationals. Look, Bangladesh nationals, this is a very good language. For Bangladesh nationals, what we have covered here, visa number, yes, date of expiry, when it will expire, type of visa, what type of visa Mita got, purpose of visit, that means why she is visiting, that is the purpose. Okay, and finally, this is the signature of a passenger. Okay, so that is you will put the signature of Mita. This is not your signature, as this form is for Mita. Okay, now, and when Mita is signing this, that very date we will write here. Okay, that means Mita is leaving which date? Can you remember? Can you remember the date? Yeah, July 14, 2012. She is leaving that very date. Okay, on that date. So we will write this date here. Okay, as Mita will sign on that date and as she is leaving on that date. Okay, so please do it very quickly. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so just put this very quickly. And seal, this is an official. If you have the seal, you can put it, or if you don't have the seal, leave it. Okay, so this is not a very mandatory thing. Just put these informations here. Okay, let's check who is doing the first. Again, camera jhapsa dekhacche. Maybe it is net issue, dear. Can you check your net? Yeah, 14-7. Thank you. Thank you, Raisa. You did it first. Congratulations. Yeah. Perhaps many of you have did it, but I saw this one first. Okay, dear. As other can see it clearly, so I think it's okay. So can you please check your devices? Yeah, now clear. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank God. Yes, T915138, visa number. Yes, September 27. Yeah. Okay, B, September 27. Okay, dear, can you write this way, 27? You will just write the date here, 27, and month, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, and September. So, which month is it? 9. So, 0, 9. You will write it here, 0 and 9. Okay. Okay, somebody asked, Miss Counter, Maniki, Counter, do you want to know the meaning of counter? If it is counter, counter is a desk, okay? It is a desk. Suppose if I want to buy a ticket, where I will go? I will go a ticket counter, a desk where the ticket is selling, okay? So, hope you understand your word. Yeah, traveling, purpose, yeah, travel or travel. It would be travel, traveling, okay, Mita, July, yeah, right answer, very good, so active students. Purpose of visit, traveling, excellent, Oshim Mondol, thank you, to visit Thailand, yes, Thailand, can you Correct the spell of Thailand. 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 Okay. Just write the traveling. Purpose traveling. Okay. Yeah. Very good. Excellent. Excellent. Thank you, dear. The answer is coming. Okay. Now let's see. So, can you tell me, dear students? Okay. Now stop writing the answer, dear. Now tell me. Ma'am, what I will write in purpose of visit? Okay. Who is giving the answer? Nabil. Okay, Nabil, can you check? Can you check the text? Look. Why Mita is going there? The visa is for, it will expire. It is a, look, it is a tourist visa. It is a tourist visa. Mita has got a tourist visa. What does it mean? That means she is going as a tourist. So what is the purpose? Only visit or travel. Okay. That means traveling is her purpose. So in the purpose you will write it here, traveling or visit. Okay. Traveling. Okay. Travelling. Dear Shahriar, can you correct the spelling? There will be two L. Traveling. LL. Thank you. What's the meaning of departure card? Departure card means bohirgamon card. Jeta amra je form ta puron korchi, actually this is the departure card. Okay, that means this is the form. Actually it is a form. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ashraf Ahmed. Thank you. Very good. Excellent. Thank you, Habib. Yeah, now this is the right answer. So many right answers are coming. Okay, now let's move to our next activity. So what we have learned here, how we can fulfill the form. We have done this form for Mita. Okay, now, okay, so this is the form. Somebody asked that what is the departure card. It is actually a form. This is a card and it is called departure card, and just we have filled it for Mita. Okay, now what you will do, you will just fill it for you. Okay, so you can say that, ma'am, I don't have the passport, I don't have a visa, then how can I put it? Okay, if you are in this situation, then you will just put this number, just an imaginary number. Okay, passport number, you know how to write the passport number. There will be a number A, B or B, C like this, and then some figure. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. So passport number, just imaginary. If you don't have the passport, you will write it here. So actually what is the thing, how we will write the form. Hope you understand how we can fill in a departure card, isn't it? Okay, I think it is very easy now for you. Okay, so do it for yourself, and if you have completed it, just take a snap and send it through comments. Okay, very good. Now look at this question. If you have a passport, tell me when you got it and which country have you already visited. Okay, so this is a question not for you all, that is who have the passport, you can easily give the answer. But if you don't have the passport, the very students who don't have the passport, can you tell me that would you like to have one and why? If yes, that yes, I want to have a passport. So give me your answer. Okay, why you need a passport? Just 30 seconds I will give you, that if you have passport, you will write yes, put a comma and write the name of the countries you visited. Okay. And if you don't have the passport, you write down, do you need it? You will write yes or no. And if your answer is yes, then you will write why you need it. Okay. So please write it in short. Okay. Yeah. Very good. Yes, I have a passport. Yes, Jahan Shumi, If you have a passport, then tell me which countries have you visited? Yes. Yes. Because it will help me to go another country. Excellent. Excellent answer, Rafiqul Islam. Thank you. Thank you. Nice class. Thank you. Thank you so much. No, I don't have a passport. Okay, fine. If you don't have a passport, then do you want a passport? Yes, I want to have a passport because I want to visit South Korea. Excellent. Firoza Yasmin. Very nice answer. Yes, thank you. That means without a passport, we cannot visit other countries. Very good. Very good. Yeah. Yeah. So many students have passport and they have visited. Yes. Nabila Zaman, me also. Yeah. Nice. Nice comments. Very good. My IELTS exam, but I don't go into any country yet. Okay. Somebody has the passport but don't have visited any country. Okay. It may happen. Then think which country you like to visit. Yes, yes, yes. Very good. Very nice answers are coming. So I think you got the text very well because you are telling the right thing. Because without passport, we cannot visit other countries. If we want to visit other countries or we want to study abroad, we must have a passport. Okay. So actually, we have come at the very end of our today's class. So just to wrap up, I must say, and what so far we have learned. We have learned some vocabulary. Can you remember? We have learned 4 vocabs and use them in sentences. Can you remember? Yeah. Seen a departure card, a form. So we have seen a departure card. We also feel it, isn't it? Read a text and understood it. Yeah. We have understood the text. We have filled in a form. We have filled in a form. Very good. And we have discussed about the necessity of visa and passport, isn't it? We have talked about the necessity of visa. If you have a passport but you don't have the visa, so visa is the formal permission. So if you don't have the visa, how will you visit abroad? Okay, so this is very important. Without visa and passport, we will not be able to go abroad. So we have also discussed this. So I think this will be very informative class for you. If you want to go abroad, this how to fill the departure card, you can fill it very confidently, I must say. So you will not be able to take any help from others, rather you will help your parents as well, isn't it? Okay, so that's all for now, and hope you enjoyed the class. See you in the next class. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum.